What is dementia? Dementia is not a specific disease or condition, but rather it's a term used to describe a group of symptoms, including memory loss, impaired judgment, a decline in intellect and problem solving, and other cognitive skills that affects a person's ability to perform everyday activities. A good way to visualize this is to see dementia as an umbrella. The umbrella is made up of various symptoms that I just described, and under the umbrella are all of the different diseases and conditions which could cause these symptoms. I'll talk about these different diseases and conditions in a future segment, but for now, it's important to note that these diseases and conditions fall into two categories: those which are potentially treatable and reversible if identified and treated soon enough, and those which are irreversible and progressive, like the most common form of dementia, which is Alzheimer's disease. How does dementia affect our aging population? Based on the research, 7 to 10% of those 65 and older have some form of dementia. However, these numbers rise dramatically with increased age, with over 40% of the population 85 and older suffering from some form of dementia. So what does all this mean? It means that 1 in 3 seniors will die of Alzheimer's or some other type of dementia, that Alzheimer's is the 6th leading cause of death in the U.S. and the only top 10 cause of death in America that cannot currently be prevented, cured, or slowed. And currently, Alzheimer's and other dementias cost our nation $226 billion. And by 2050, with the aging of the baby boomers, these costs will rise to $1.1 trillion. How do we distinguish between what is normal aging versus what is a potential dementia? Have you ever lost your keys or had trouble finding your car in a crowded parking lot? Of course you have. We all do, and no one really thinks twice about it. Yet if you were in your 70s, 80s, or 90s, everyone, including yourself, might begin to question if you had some form of dementia. So let's look at what are some of the normal aging-related changes to memory, since this is a key symptom of dementia. I'd like you to think of your brain like a computer. What happens when the memory in your computer gets really full? It takes longer to process and retrieve information. So think of the aging brain in the same way. You can still process or learn new information and retrieve or recall stored information from your memory. It just takes a little longer. Why? Because you have so much more information in your brain to sift through. So take an 80-year-old individual. You ask them a question, and they have that experience where the answer to your question is right on the tip of their tongue, and in a minute or two, they can answer your question. This is normal aging. However, if a minute or two later, they don't even remember the question, this is not normal and should be seen as a red flag for potential dementia. And that person should be seen by a doctor for a full diagnostic assessment. Hopefully you've learned a little more about dementia. In my next video segment, I'll explore many of the diseases and conditions that cause dementia symptoms, as well as their clinical course and diagnostic assessment.